And in this chapter, in this video, we are going to see few questions based on gravitational potential and gravitational potential energy, right? So in the previous video, we had discussed about what is gravitational potential and what is gravitational potential energy, right? So after solving these questions based on potential and potential energy, we'll go for escape speed and escape energy, right? See, the question is, at what height from the surface of the earth the gravitation potential and value of G are -5.4 × 10⁻⁷ and 6 m/s² respectively. Take the radius of earth as 6400 km. Okay, so this was the question asked in NEET 2016. See what the question says: from the surface of the earth, at what height the gravitational potential is -5.4 × 10⁻⁷ and G is 6 m/s². So at what height will the value of potential and G becomes this? Okay, so potential is minus G m by r, right, where r will be r e plus h, because this is earth, this is the radius r e, center. Suppose at this height the value of potential and acceleration becomes this, right? So at this height, let the value of potential and G will be -5.4 × 10⁻⁷ and 6. Say this has height h, this is r e, so this will be r, which is equals to r e plus h. Is it clear? Right, let h be the height from the surface of the earth where the value of potential, where the potential and G be 5.4 × 10⁻⁷ and 6 m/s². Okay, so this is the formula for calculating gravitational potential. Okay, so they have given G as 6. So let us multiply this equation by r and divide. Multiply the equation by r and divide it by r. So gravitational potential is minus G m by r square into r. What is G m by r square? G, right? So V is -5.4 × 10⁻⁷ equals to -6 × r. But what is r? R plus h. 6.9, right, into 10⁻⁷ equals to r plus h. What is r? 6400 km. So that is, let us say 6.4 × 10⁻⁶, right, plus h. Okay, 6400 km, na? R equals to 6400 km. So 6.4 × 10⁵ m. So 6.4 × 10⁶. Okay, that is correct. So this can be written as 9 × 10⁶ equals to 6.4 × 10⁶ plus h. Subtract this. So this will be 2.6 × 10⁶ equals to h. So h will be 2600 km. So from the surface of the earth at a height of 2600 km, the gravitational potential and the value of G will be this, right? Okay, let us solve another question. Another question on potential: infinite number of masses each of 1 kg are placed along x axis at ±1 m, ±2, ±4, 8, 16, up to infinite. You have to find the magnitude of gravitational potential at the origin. Okay, so mass is 1 kg, right? So 1 kg mass is placed along x-axis at 1, 2, 4, 8, right? So at each and everywhere you place the mass of 1 kg. You have to find the magnitude of gravitational potential. Okay, magnitude of gravitational potential. So magnitude of gravitational potential will be, because of this mass placed at this point, at this point, at this, at this, it all will be added up, because the value of gravitational potential will be gm by r, right? But gm by r1 in our case, gm by r2, gm by r3, gm by r4, and the same over negative x-axis. So we'll do one thing, I'll write this as the total potential will be 2gm 1 by r1, 1 by r2, 1 by r3, 1 by r4, dot 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 dot, right? I've multiplied 2 over here because the masses which are placed along positive x-axis, the same masses are placed over negative x-axis. So we'll calculate the potential because of this masses and multiplied by 2. So we can get the total potential because of each and every mass. Is it clear? Right. See, masses are placed at both positive and negative x-axis this way. Right. So we'll calculate the potential over this side and multiply it by 2. So we'll get the total potential. And since they have asked for the magnitude of gravitational potential at origin, so I have not placed a minus sign. Right. Okay. So now this terms, you can check it, that the ratio of first, second and first term, fourth and third and second term, fourth and third term, the ratios are equal. That means the term is in geometric progression, GP. So for infinite terms, the addition will be A upon 1 minus R, magnitude of R, where A represents your first term and R represents the ratio of second is to first, third is to second, fourth is to third, this is R. So A is 1, 1 minus R, the ratio of second is to first will be 1 by 2 or third is to 2 will be 1 by 2, so it will be 1 by 2. So this will be 2, 1 upon 1 by 2. So your answer is V is equals to 2gm, right, into the whole answer is 2. So your answer will be 4gm. This is what is the value of gravitational potential at the origin because of all the masses, right? So now we'll solve the question based on potential energy. Okay, so the next question, energy required to move a body of mass m from an orbit of radius 2r to 3r. So what is the energy required to move a mass m from an orbit of radius 2r to 3r? So this will be 3r. So you just have to move this mass from 2r to 3r, right? Okay. So the arrangement, the configuration of this mass is changing, right? So entire work done will be converted into potential energy. So what is the initial potential energy? Initial is minus g m, another mass is, okay, capital M upon 2R. Final energy will be minus G M M upon 3R, right? So work done is equals to M is the mass of this and capital M will be the mass of this. So work done is final minus initial. So this is minus G M capital M by 3R, minus of minus, so it will be plus gm m by 2r. So gm m by r will be taken common, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. So this will be equals to gm m by r into 1 by 6. So this is the answer. So this is the work required to be done to move a body of mass m from an orbit of 2r to an orbit of 3r. Okay, so the gravitational potential energy of a body of mass m at Earth's surface is given as minus mgre. So potential energy of a body of mass m lying on the surface of the Earth, say mass m, potential energy is given as minus mgre. Okay, now you are, they are saying to calculate potential energy at a height re from the earth surface, where r is the radius. Okay, so what will be the potential energy of this mass at a height h equals to re? Okay, see, potential energy, if you are directly writing, is minus mg, total will be re and re, so it will be 2re. So if you are placing here 2re, but make sure that this g will be changing, so you need to calculate g at this particular height, right? See, the value of g they are giving, that is on the surface of the earth. When object is placed on the surface of the earth, we already know that when a body is taken to certain height, the value of acceleration will change. So if you are directly using this formula, minus mg into r, where r equals to re plus re, so that is 2re, but you need to find the value of g at this height, right? So say g of h, so g of h upon g of e equals to re square upon re plus h the whole square. So it is re square upon re plus re the whole square, so re square upon 4re square. So value of acceleration at height h will be g by 4, because acceleration on the surface of the earth is equals to g. So now substitute this value in this equation, so energy will be minus m into, instead of g of h, we'll write it as g by 4 into 2re. Clear? So energy will be minus mg re by 2. Fine. So we have seen the questions based on gravitational potential and gravitational potential energy, right? So in the next video, we'll discuss a very important topic: what is escape energy, what is escape speed, and how to calculate escape speed.